introduction to fractions of amounts. If as I get started, you start scratching your head, then go back and look at the previous video, which is on this resource called Fractions of Numbers. If you scroll down, you'll see underneath an embedded video, which goes through where you start when trying to find a fraction of a number and gives you concrete resources, physical things you can manipulate to see how the process works. This video is just jumping on from that, where we'll be looking at visual ways of representing it straight away, and then moving on to written methods of representing finding fractions of an amount. We'll be looking at a couple of questions taken from this PowerPoint. Let's get started. So if I needed to find that out, 1/6 of 24, then we need to know that this is the total. I have to share it by the denominator. The denominator, if you remember, tells us how many equal groups we have to make, how many equal parts we have to cut the number into. I have to cut that into 6 equal groups. You may also remember, think back to when you were in key stage 1 and you used arrays. So I would have 24, and if I want to share that into 6 equal groups, you might have, when looking at a division problem like 24 divided by 6, spread it out using counters to make an array. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 equal groups, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. I've got 24 items and I've shared them equally into 6 groups because the denominator tells me to make 6 equal groups. The numerator tells me how many of those equal groups I count. So this is a unit fraction, there's a 1 at the top. I have to count 1 of my groups. Done. So 1/6 of 24 equaled 4. If that becomes a non-unit fraction and goes to a 2/6, then I would need to count 2 of my groups. You see? So by visually representing it, I hope that's a quick reminder of what the denominator tells you to do and what the numerator tells you to do. Now, if you were looking at that as a bar model, if you have 24 as the whole, and we've already worked out that there's 4 in each group. Again, I could have done that by using more written methods like 24 divided by, and I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 divided by 6. If you forgot, we were trying to find 1/6 of 24. So I had to split my bar into 6 equal groups and share 24 into 6 equal groups. That gave us 4. We know that one of those six equal groups is 4. Therefore, if this changes to 2, then I would have to count 2 groups. If I didn't even have a bar model, I could still work it out by just using a written method. So let's go with, what would 5/6 of 24 be? Well, I have to do 24 and I have to divide it by 6. Now, you can either use, of course, your division number facts to do that. Oh, I know, 24 divided by 6 is 4. Or flip it, do the inverse, count up in 6s until you get to 24. 6, 12, 18, 24. So I counted 4 times to get to 24. 24 divided by 6 equals 4. But remember, I'm not trying to find one group, I'm trying to find 5 groups. So the next thing I have to do is take this number, 4, and times it by the numerator. Because that's your repeated addition. That's, if you're looking at the array, going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's the 5 there. I have to count 5 of my groups. So 4 lots of 5. 5 lots of 4. Which would be 20. So 5/6 of 24 equals 20. Have a look at this question here. Now, you might not be able to read it on my screen, so I'll read it aloud now. In the winter, the children in class 5 wear either jumpers or cardigans. There's an important piece of information in there, but we'll come back to it. There's some other stuff there that's trying to hide it. 3/5 of the children wear jumpers, 10 children wear cardigans. So how many children wear jumpers? Well, we know 10 children wear cardigans, but it only says 3/5 of the children wear jumpers. So how do we work that out? Well, let's start with a bar model. So we've already been given our fraction. If you heard it, it was 3/5, which means I need to cut my bar, my class, my whole class, into 5 parts. Now, the key bit of information in that top sentence that might have just slipped by you there was that the children, not some of the children, but the children, which means all of the children. So all of the children are either wearing a jumper or a cardigan. We know that 3/5 of them are wearing a jumper. So let's call this our jumper crew. These are our jumpers. And these guys over here, these are our cardigans. These are 10. So this big box has 10 children in it. It says 10 children are wearing cardigans. What is 10 split into 2? What is 10 divided by 2? Good. So now we know what each of our fifths is worth. Which means we can keep going. 5, 5, 5. There must be 25 children in the class. 3/5 of 25. Now you could, of course, can either go, well, 5, 10, 15. Or, of course, you could have done 25 divided by 5. 25 divided by 5, which is 5. And then times that by the numerator. So the 5 times 3 to get the same answer, 15. So when you're looking at fractions of an amount or fractions of a number, remember to divide the whole number by the denominator, then times it by the numerator. Draw bar models or arrays or get physical resources or anything else you need to help you. Good luck and enjoy.